In this video, you will learn how to create a prezi effect in PowerPoint presentation. And if you are not aware of prezi is an online presentation tool, and this is their website, and most of their plans are paid, and these are their prices at the moment, as you can see. But if you go to this basic, they also have a free basic account which I have created recently, and this presentation tool provides you some very fantastic effects in your presentations. So when you open a free account, you will get this console, something like this, and the effect which we are going to implement in PowerPoint is demonstrated in one of their getting started presentations. And if I click on that, now we get this presentation. The way this effect works is that this is your first slide of the presentation, let us assume, and on this slide you have certain objects, these circular shapes, and within those objects you have certain icons. And whenever you click on any of these objects, let's say I click on this, it presents me with a different slide, and on this slide I can explain whatever I want to explain, any idea or any part of my presentation. And I can even go further down one level. If I click on this, it will present me another slide. This is very attractive for presenting work, for both for students or for teachers. And now if you roll the wheel of your mouse, you can come back to one step, and if you roll it again, you will come back to the main slide. So the idea is that you control all of your presentation from your single slide. So from top slide, you have all other slides connected, and wherever you want to go, you go into that slide by clicking and then explain the idea, then just roll your mouse back or click, because in Prezi you can come back by rolling the mouse wheel. In PowerPoint we will come back by clicking. So this is the effect which we are going to learn today, how we can get this effect in PowerPoint. So what we are going to make in this video is, this is our main slide. It's a very simple slide. It has four objects, and when I click on this object, it zooms in, it presents another slide. I explain the concept here, what are the meanings of these two. Then I click, I go back to my main slide, and then I click on the next icon. It shows my slide in which there are some details. I explain these details. How I do that? I just click again. I go outside, and then the next one. Then I explain where I publish my courses. Then I click, I go out. Then the last one. Then I explain how I promote my courses. I click on there, and the slides and the presentation is finished. So this is what we are going to learn in this video, how to make this fantastically simple but elegant presentation. So let's get started. So we start from a blank slide, the title of the slide. Let's insert the text box, type just here a simple four-step formula for selling online courses, and the font we want is this one, Hatton Chiviller, and the size we want is 40, and let's keep it in the center a little bit downward. Now we have to insert four shapes. So insert shapes, and the shape we like is this display from flowcharts. So we just put here and then rotate it in the other direction. We want to make three copies, so Control D, and now we adjust the spaces between them. And the best way to align these is to using this arrange tab and align to the top, and then we can also distribute them equally in horizontal direction. You can also make a little bit of adjustment on both sides if you want. And now select all these, and in the shape fill, we don't want any fill, no fill, but we want this outline. And now we just put some text inside this, insert the text box, plan, and the font I like is Rockwell Nova, and the size is 18 is fine. And now we insert another text box in this, and this is produce, and on the same line horizontally. And now we have to insert the icon, so insert icons. This is fine for the planning. Again, icons, insert icons. We can actually select all these together. we need a gear icon. So this is for production. So for promoting, this is fine. So we insert these icons here, and now we just put it in appropriate places, just like that. Very simple. And now what we can do now is select these two, and when this four arrows appear, you just right click and group. Similarly, select these two, and then on this double-sided arrows, we right click and we group. So now everyone is a single group. So now what we want to do is we want to save all these. So I have seen many videos on internet. They explain this so long, but actually it's a very simple two-line trick which we can use to get this zoom slide function. So now what we need to do is we just select this and we right click and save as picture. And this is the folder in which I have already saved these three pictures. I will save this as plan. Similarly, now right click on this and save as picture, and I give it a name, produce, and now this one, save as picture, and I say publish. Then click this one, save as picture, promote. So this is one of the important steps, select those icons as images are as pictures, and then we create the slides. And now we have to make these four slides. So right click here and new slide. We have to delete this, and the first slide is plan. So we insert a text box here and plan. So just increase the font to maybe a little bit up to, this is fine, and we want this font as well as Hatton Schueller. And let's say there are only two steps here, so we have to insert two icons. So one is this one and the other is this one. So we just insert. On the right hand side, you can see that PowerPoint is giving you certain design ideas if you wish, otherwise you can close this. So only these two steps, so we just put it there, and we say we can enlarge this so that we can put some text inside this. It's too big, so let's move it a little bit smaller. And now we insert a text box, adjust the position a little bit, and another text box for this one. So this is our slide number two. Now we want to add another slide. So instead of adding from here, if you add from here, you can straight away add the blank slide. And now the third slide is produce. So again, we insert a text box and we just drag this. And now here we want to have five different steps. We also want some arrows. So insert shapes, and the arrow we want here is this one. Make an arrow here. And now we want some icons here. So insert icons, this one. Then this is for thumbnail. So this is transcript. So let's say this is for recording, this is for editing. So insert. And now we want to put the text as well in front so that someone can understand what we mean. You can select all these, arrange, align, align left, and now the slide number four. So new slide and blank slide, publish. We have three places to publish and we want arrows as well. So insert, this is the arrow number one, control D two times. Let's say this oval shape. And now we want the color of these arrows to be black. So we select all these and shape fill black and control D twice, adjust here, and we want the color of these three to be orange. Let's say orange. And now we want to insert text here. Okay, so now this slide is also ready. And now we want slide number five, which is the promote slide. Again, insert text box. And now we have three arrows. So insert shape, and we want, let's say, these three arrows. So change the color first. Let's say use this gray color. Control D twice to make two more copies. So now I have created three pictures. So insert picture. And from here, these are the three platforms where I promote. So I just copy these three pictures and insert. just put it here.
I created these pictures in Canva. So Canva is free. This is the slide number 5, and now we are ready to make the effect. So just go to first slide, and now we just delete these 4 because we have to put images here. So I will do one by one so that you can understand the step. So this is the last and final step. So what we do is we click on insert, and in this zoom there is an option slide zoom. So click on slide zoom, and now we have to just put the slide which we want. So for plan, our slide was this one. So we want this slide to be inserted here. Now the slide has been inserted here, and now you have to click on this format. So click on format on the left hand side, check this return to zoom, and click on change image. It will ask you to select the picture. So you say from a file, and now we select the plan picture. This is the picture which we saved earlier. So select this and insert. And now you can delete this one because this picture is irrelevant now. We just want to put this picture here. So now this picture actually is replaced our slide. So when we will click on this, the slide will show. The same thing you have to do for these 4, and your presentation will be ready. So let's quickly do that. I go on insert, zoom, slide zoom, this slide, insert. Now click on format, check this, change image from the file, and the second image. So delete this group and put this image. So now you can delete these 2 as well, because now you know what you are doing. So just insert, zoom, slide zoom, select the next slide, not this one, this one, and insert. Now click on format, check this, change the image from the file, promote, sorry, publish, insert. Now the last one, insert, slide zoom, click this slide, insert, click format, check return to zoom, change image from the file, last image, promote. And now everything is ready. If you want to remove these squares which you can see, you can just click on this and go to this shape outline and no outline. Click on this shape outline, no outline. Repeat the process for these 2, and now everything is ready, and now I'm starting the slideshow. So I will just keep this a little bit lower so that you can see, because my screen capture is capturing only this part. So slideshow, and now if I click on this, as you can see that we are zooming into the slide, and when I click again, I zoom out. Then I click on this, we zoom in. Then I click again and we zoom out. So how cool is this? It looks incredibly fantastic. So just click on this. You explain your concept here. When you are done, click again, you come out, you explain the next. So it looks fantastic. It looks very attractive. Whether you are a student presenting your PhD work, or you are a teacher presenting your lecture on any subject, and you have modules or subtitles of your main lecture, you can explain in a decent way. If you like, you can give it a color, but color doesn't matter. It's a personal choice. Whatever color you want, you can give it. So this is how you make this prezi effect using PowerPoint.